All right, go. Quick, the routine, just jogging, focusing on the form. And this one, jog, kick your foot. You're gonna be running around the court, so half of the court you're gonna be doing it with one leg, half of the court with another leg. Now high knees, making sure when you're doing high knees, utilize your arms, knees gonna be going higher than your hip or same level as the hip. Now this next lap, you're gonna be focusing on the height, control your elbows, making sure your elbows not going away from your body. And the back pedal exploding up, again. Big stride, big stride. When you're doing gazelle jumps, you can be doing laps, break it down, go from one to line. Spend more time in the air. And the last one, the eighth lap, you can just do sprints from line to line. All right, here we go, two stretch bends, one on your ankles, one on the knees. So you step out, squat, bring it in. Making sure your knees are wide, you're not creating letter A. You're gonna leading with the other leg. Now making sure that your head is all the time within your legs. You're not leaning to the side when you're trying to step out with your foot. The same thing, like you on skis, going forward. One, staying low, and here you go. Your toes are pointing forward all the time. You're gonna go all the way forward to center line and then back. All right, same thing, now going backwards, making sure your knees are apart. Again, you're not creating letter A. Now you're just gonna do 10 lifts like this with the foot. Make sure your elbows are close to your body. You will see in here that your right elbow goes to the side. Here you go, balance your head, kick it, and again, making sure your knee is not going inside. That's why it's good to do all this exercise in front of the mirror. All right, gonna start, go. Start throwing 10 catches from the wall, moving back, moving forward. You're only gonna count the ones that you catch. If the ball drops, you don't count those. Catch 10, and then we'll move to the next drill. Right here, just gonna be 1 minute of jump rope. Idea in here is not to make a mistake. Or you're closing your eyes, you're picturing, you're visualizing how you're rallying. You're not making unforced error. If you make an unforced error, if your jump rope gets tangled, just bounce back and go again. But idea in here is not to make a mistake in 1 minute. Seeing is believing. So you have to see yourself staying in the rally long enough, becoming a wall. Right now, for 1 minute straight, you're just gonna be doing volleying. This is great in here. We have a windows in front. So if you have a mirror, just shadow swinging into the mirror in front of you so you can see yourself, so you can have a blueprint of a swing. You can be going for a low volley, high volley, mid volleys, everything. Okay, right now, throwing motions against the wall. The same thing. Try to catch 10 balls off a wall. If it drops down, you don't count it. All right, use your legs, you're gonna breathe out, let the athlete out. Again, 1 minute on the jump rope, same thing. 1 minute, no mistakes, no unforced errors. Close your eyes and going, bounce back and go. You can keep track how many mistakes you made. All right now we're gonna start with a serve, following up with a volley, and then run back with an overhead. Again, you're gonna be in front of the mirror, running back. Right away, bounce the ball. Where your eyes are gonna go? Eyes on the bounce, eyes on the target, eyes on the contact. You're breathing. Right away, come in. Again, have a plan right away. Not such a heavy step. Lighter step, Benjo. All right, go. Running and throwing forehands. Same thing, using your legs. Sit in the chair. Going for the loop, controlling your head. Making sure your head is not lifting up. Remember, on the ground strokes, the racket goes up, body goes up. Head stays down. Again, a minute on the jump rope. Again, eyes closed. At the same time, you can be visualizing how you serve. You can be visualizing how you're hitting volleys. You can be planning out. You can be visualizing how you're going through a six ball drill. All right, now ground stroke, side to side. You can be practicing even different footwork. You can be finishing over your shoulders. You can be practicing your underspin. Again, just to have a plan. Height of the contact. You can be practicing tabletop in here as well. Just 1 minute, shadow swinging, dynamic shadow swing, moving side to side, in front of the mirror. All right, now it's gonna be 10 catches from the back. And again, I wanna hear you breathe, Benjo. Again, sit low, sit in the chair, lift out, let the athlete out. Keep going, little steps. Again, recover big, throw big. Again, another minute on the jump rope. Now, you can have a break, water break. You can throw a medicine ball, jump rope for a minute, then do shadow swing for a minute, and after that you can take like a 30 to 45 second water break. You just make an unforced error again. Can't be making those unforced errors, Benjo. Stay in, just one more shot and you hit one more shot. You're gonna hit one more shot than my opponent. Alright, now this time you're gonna go 6-ball drill with a serve. In here you have to have a plan. Even when you're gonna be hitting ground strokes, are you hitting in defensive area of the red zone, offensive, neutral area, in defensive area of the court, you have to remember you have to hit 1 foot higher over the net to your whatever, how much feet you move back. If you're in offensive area of the court, you can be changing direction of the ball. Now, first round on the 6-ball drill, you're gonna have an approach shot with your forehand. Second round, 6-ball drill, it's gonna be a backhand approach shot. And the third round, you can do approach shots with an underspin. 5 lunges on each leg, again, focusing on your knees that it's not curving in. It goes in a little bit, make sure it's straight. Make sure your knees on top of your toes. You don't wanna be going in front of your toes. Then go another 5 on another knee. Again, make sure it doesn't curve in. All right, now another 5 lunges, but facing the other way, and again, focusing in your knee that it's not gonna be breaking inside or outside. Your other leg, let's go. Make sure your body is straight. And again, if you feel like your stretch band is pulling you too much, then come closer a little bit, but making sure you're doing it with the right form. Now another 5. Again, facing forward. Again, keep your body straight. Make sure your knee's not going in front of your toe. Your knee staying a little bit behind your toe. Yeah, here we go, like this. Your knee's 90 degrees. Here we go, let's go. Other leg, same thing. Focusing on balance. Don't lean forward too much. Again, making sure you're just going straight down. Here we go. Now another 5, facing the opposite way. Same thing in here. Make sure your feet are a little bit wider. You don't want to get too close to your feet. A wider lunge, and let's finish it up on another leg. Same thing, balance, and keeping your arms in front, going straight down. Just doing side steps right now. 5 times, touching the cone, coming back, bouncing your head. 5 times, touch the cone, facing me. The same 5 times, facing away from me. And again, keeping your feet wider, working from your toes, activating your calves. All right, high knees, get in front of the center line, and then come back with the split steps. Keep your head in front. All right, now sprint, touch the cone, now big strides back, big strides back. Again, little steps, go, 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 go. 5 times of this, let's go. All right, now cross the first side step, touch the cone, again, split step, cross, big cross, and back. Again, split, big cross, and side step. All right, now again, another 5 facing away from me. Again, focusing on the big cross step, try to cover more ground, split, go. All right, same thing again. Bump your knees up. Get in front of the center line. And again, split step back. Go, 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 go. Activate. And again, right away, explode forward. Go, 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 go. All right, now again, sprint. Dodge the cone. Big strides back. Big strides back. Little steps. Go, 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 go. Explode. All right, it's going to be A to be great right now. Hitting the forehand from a neutral area of the red zone. When you're hitting from a neutral area of the red zone, where are you aiming? Between A's and B's. All right, now A to be great from defensive area for red zone. Even if you're moving back, you're still gonna be moving forward on the shot, transferring your forward, hitting it aggressively. Now if you're in defensive area for red zone, you're aiming Ivan Lendl-Grid, you're centering the ball, making it easy for yourself to offer your opponent. Every foot that you move back, you're aiming 1 foot higher over the net. And now A to be great, offensive area for red zone. Now you can be changing direction of the ball. You can be aiming between the C, A, and B. Again, still, if you're going down the line, you're still aiming inside the percentage post. If you're going cross court, you're aiming inside the percentage post. The percentage line, percentage post. A to be great on the back end. Again, neutral area of a red zone. Your targets, A and B. Stepping forward, organizing your feet. You don't want to be locking your back foot. To be great. Defensive area for red zone on the back end. Again, height equals depth. If you're in defensive, create time. If you're in offensive, you have to take time. Stand up on your toes. Breathe out. Let the athlete out. Offensive area for red zone. Drive it. Now you can change direction of the ball. Again, hitting a plus. And then anticipating the ball to come up as a minus. Watching your opponent, which position they're in. Watching for that short ball. In the red zone, you're waiting for your opponent to hit the ball short, change the direction of the ball, or make a mistake.